Being a hip-hop producer these days is the next best thing to being a rapper. In fact, it might be even better. You get all the attention and recognition without the grueling tour schedule. After all, your whole job is to be in the studio, making music. So how do you get there? What do you need to know in order to become the next Zaytoven or London on the track? We've got 5 steps for you to follow so that, with a ton of practice and networking, you can end up with your very own annoying producer tag. Rule number 1, find a mentor. For now, pretty much every producer learns the craft on their own. There's some interesting early steps being taken towards beatmaking being something you can learn in the classroom, but we're not really there yet. So it's key to find someone you can learn from.
The guy that showed me the ropes was JT the Bigger Figure. He was the guy, he was like, you know, a Bay Area boss already. He was making music, doing record deals, and doing all type of things. He was the one that saw me playing the keyboard and like, man, let me take you to the studio. You know, he says, Zay, you might not do nothing. You might just be a fly on the wall, but you need to be in this atmosphere of all these people. So I was just watching. I was just soaking up the game and watching how they get down. You know, how these guys put songs together and showed me how the MPC works with the keyboard. And once he showed me how that function, he was like, here, cool. Now stay here. You can play with it all day. I'm gonna go somewhere. I got to run off. Here, you can sit and play with the equipment all day. So that's really what it was. I was just learning the process of song making when I was around all these other producers and rappers. It'll be B Legit, E-40, the Dog Pound, you know, just a lot of Bay Area guys at the time. So, but what I learned is these guys would do this day in and day out. It'll be 4 o'clock in the morning, they still recording till the sun come up, and then the next day they doing that all over again. So it lets me know I had to be diligent and staying in the studio and working hard.
Rule number 2, deconstruct the classics. One of the best ways to learn how to make beats is to figure out how other people already did it.
Well, I taught myself drums. I picked up drums probably like when I was like 8. And then how I learned how to play drums was I would just like listen to music and headphones, just like play along to it. So that's how I kind of taught myself. It goes the same for making beats. I just picked up the program and just taught myself how to make beats. Started messing around with it, experimenting, getting used to the program, and then just making music. I'd make like type beats, like that was like a thing on the internet. I think it still is. I'd make like a type of beat, like a Waka Flocka type beat or like Slim Duncan type beat and stuff, you know? It's a way to like experiment and I guess practice, right? But it's just mainly right now, I just feel like it's like the 10,000 hour rule, right? It's like the more you practice at something, the better you get. So no matter like what type of beat or like how you're making it, you're gonna get better at what you do.
Was nobody really trying to learn how to play the organ or the piano, so I would go and watch the guy that was playing the organ at the time. His name was Sheldon Harrington, and I would just go sit by him. Every time he played the organ, I'd sit there and try to just learn and pick up things. And me learning to play music by watching people and learning how to play from ear, it's kind of where I start getting my creativity from. Because a lot of times I might not play the song exactly how I heard it, but you know, I was playing it, you know, close to how it sounded. So it's like my own rendition of what I heard. I remember when I first started to make beats, DJ Quick was like one of my favorite producers to listen to. So I would listen to him and listen to the beats that he was making, and I'd try to go in and recreate the beats that he made. And I felt like if I can make something that sound just as good as this or make it sound like how he made it sound, then maybe I'm pretty good. So, you know, that's how I definitely started doing that. But once you try to mimic somebody else or try to make something somebody else did, it's not gonna sound exactly like how they sounded. So that's when you start, you know, filling out your own creativity. Like, okay, well, mine don't sound exactly like that, but mine got a certain other little twist to it, you know, so. And that's kind of helped me with my creativity also.
Even the great J Dilla himself used this technique. Denon Porter told us about a time he went to Dilla's house and saw JD and the legendary producer Pete Rock working together trying to reconstruct a DJ Premier beat. But if you don't have Pete Rock right in front of you, you can find plenty of videos breaking down how beats are made on YouTube. Everyone from DJ Dahi to Marley Marl has done tutorials on how they made their hit songs. Rule number 3, build out your library. A key to becoming a successful producer is having a recognizable sound. Whether it's DJ Premier, Pharrell, or Big Head on the beat, you can usually tell your favorite beat makers within the first few seconds of hearing a track. For you to reach that point, you'll need to go through a whole lot of trial and error. So, as a new producer, you should expose yourself to as many sounds as possible. Whether you're digging for records, taking a deep dive on YouTube, or investing in a sound kit from your favorite producer, get as much source material as you can so that you can discover what you like. On a related note, make sure you keep your files organized so that when you find sounds you love, you're able to locate them again.
I think if you're doing hip-hop music, especially trap music, you definitely have to be time efficient. Because the artists that I work with, or the artists that's popular now, everybody's kind of impatient. And there's so much music coming out nowadays. You don't have all day to spend on making one song. You know, you have to make, my goal was to make 10 songs a day. When Gucci come over, we're trying to make 10 songs a day. You know, because out of these 10 songs, you know, two of them might be hit records, you know, and they give us more to listen to. When you ride in your car, I don't just ride around listen to the one song we did yesterday all day. We want to listen to more than that. So I learned that, you know, time is a very valuable thing in this music industry, because guys are ready to rap. They ready to rap. You got a beat now, put it on, turn it on. I want to make the song. All right, pull up another beat. And if you can't do that, then you're going to be lost.
Rule number four, master your existing resources. Gone are the days when you needed to spend tens of thousands of dollars to get your career off the ground. Today, even top producers like Steve Lacy are making music using only their phones. So don't let a lack of equipment hold you back. You can make great beats using whatever you have in front of you and just level up when you're ready.
All the producers I know right now, they never had a musical background or knew how to play piano and stuff. They kind of just taught themselves how to drum program and create melodies on software. But obviously, if you know the theory and how to actually play an instrument, it's obviously you have an upper hand, right? I wish I did. I wish I knew how to play the piano properly. I taught myself scales and stuff, just making beats and stuff. I kind of crossed over from rock music to punk to metal to rap. So I was playing a lot of Travis Barker remixes, because he was remixing rap songs. And then from there, that's when I traded my drum set for an electric drum set. And then when I started producing, I traded my electric drum set for a keyboard. And that's when I started making beats.
Rule number five, develop a support network. When it comes to being a producer, no one can do it alone. It's important to develop a network of peers who you can trade ideas and experiences with.
Well, one thing I always try to encourage up-and-coming producers is to latch on to an artist. Find somebody that you believe in. Find somebody you feel like can make it in the music industry. Somebody that'll do whatever it takes to become a star. Because that's the way I made it. The way I became popular is I found somebody I felt like, dang, this person is a star. This person's gonna make it. Let me produce for him. Let me come up and create a sound with this person and be that guy that he needs me to be. So when he blows up, I blow up.
I feel like if you're an upcoming artist or something, or producer, and you find someone on YouTube that you like, or you think that you're a fan of, they have potential, you lose nothing in trying to work with them, right? I would just, if I was an upcoming producer and I found some guy with 1,000 views, just send him beats, because you never know, you could have the next hit, he could be the next upcoming superstar, you know? You can't just make beats and just wait for one day to play your beat for Kanye, because that's just not how it works. I guess it could work, right? But
that never worked for me. I always used to feel like if I send these guys beats, you know, that it'll get on an album. If I send, you know, a record label that has a new artist, you know, that they would like my beats and try to get me placed on an album. But it never worked that way. I never got any calls back or nothing like that. So that's why I spent so much time and focus on the artist I had that was coming to my house every day. So I know if I'm working with Gucci Mane every day and he blow up, then that means I blow up. So I ain't gotta try to, you know, pitch my beats to everybody and they don't really get it or understand it. If OJ the Juice Man blow up, then, you know, I know they gonna always want my beats. So if Migos blow up, then, you know, I know they gonna want my beats.
Just remember, your network is your net worth. Use social media to your advantage, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Get in contact with people, go to these music conferences, fly to where you have to fly. Get comfortable with being uncomfortable. If you're just comfortable in your basement making beats all day, nothing's gonna happen. You gotta put yourself in uncomfortable situations and get comfortable with being in uncomfortable situations to succeed. You have to take risks. Just being in LA with broke, with no money, sleeping on floors and couches, living with amigos when no one had money, stuff like that, you know? Spending your last dollars on a flight to go somewhere. Or just, you know what I mean? You have to take risks. Scared money don't make no money, you know?
I'm a fan of giving the work away for free, just because, you know, if you're trying to come up, you're trying to make a name for yourself, you gotta let your work speak, you know? It's so many people that they wanna hold on to their music and wait on some money to come, or they want to sell it. Somebody got to come buy it when it's like it's a million producers out here that just want a shot. They're not even looking for the money right now. They're just looking for a chance to be heard. So, and that's the way I came up. Like when I was passing out beats, I used to take a CD that had 40 beats on it and give it to all the rappers. You know, here, take these beats, go rap. All I want you to do is rap on them. Forget about the money. I don't want no money right now. Because if one of these songs blow up, I'm going to make way more money than what I was going to charge you anyway. So that was my theory behind it.
If you followed our advice so far, you should be doing pretty well for yourself. Now it's time to start giving back. Make sure you share the lessons you've learned from your mentors and peers.
That goes back to like when you were saying when Mike Will or Metro want to come over or Sonny Digital. When they come over the house, I'm open arms. It's like, you know. And these guys probably weren't even, you know, popular yet. It's just, come on, man, come on over here. They might ask me, well, how you do that? Or what you know, where you get this sound from? Or how you use this? And I show them with no problem, because that's just my character. And I want to give and help somebody else. So when they do blow up, they can say, oh, nah, Zaytoven rock with me way back in the day.
So if you follow these 5 steps, you'll be in great shape to start your career as a producer.
Just one thing, just have a lawyer. Don't sign anything without a lawyer. Like, I don't know why people do that. Just get a lawyer. Fucking making beats or doing this or doing that, just invest that money into yourself and getting a lawyer, because it could either like save, it could either create, you could generate a career off that, or you could like stunt your growth of having a career in that industry.